Click subscribe and bell icon to get regular notifications.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. VENKAT RAMAN KOLA, Clinical Director, Department of Critical Care Medicine here. We are talking about the awareness related to the corona spread. Be safe, be kind, be responsible. This is the slogan today. Coronavirus spreads mainly through the droplets, that is the respiratory secretions, like when somebody coughs, somebody sneezes. These droplets can contaminate the other person's respiratory system when they breathe. That's the one route. The other route, which we are now commonly coming across, through the fomites. What is that? Is when somebody sneezes, these droplets drop on the animated, subanimated objects, and from there, through the contact, these things again go to your nose when you touch your hand with nose, mouth or eyes, and this can also transmit through contact. So there are two routes. One is through the droplets when you sneeze, cough. The other one is through the contact of your hand to the nose and mouth. Masks are not generally required for a normal layman at a common places or a public places. Masks may be useful in healthcare settings when a healthcare worker like a nurse or a doctor caring this kind of patients or the patients with respiratory symptoms. Mask may be helpful when a patient has symptoms like cough and breathlessness with high grade fever. They may use the mask to protect the other members to get infected, or a family member when they are caring a patient with known COVID or any respiratory symptoms. But it should not be used for the common public, whereas we have seen that the common surgical or a medical mask can sometimes be harmful and infecting more if you don't know how to use it. So we ask to refrain from using masks in a normal common public. First of all, the common population or a public should not be chasing for the masks. They should be using whenever they are sneezing, coughing, or whenever there is a respiratory decay, they try to use the elbow as a protection, and they can use tissues where if whenever somebody coughs, and the tissues can be actually disposed into a closed bin. I think hand washing will be the ideal choice if it is available. And with the soap water is as effective as hand sanitizer, so there is no need to panic and roam around for hand sanitizer in the market where we are seeing a shortfall of it. But in the same time, if you have a hand sanitizer with you and there is no hand wash facility, you can still use a hand sanitizer in those situations. See, as I already explained you, the transmission just not happens with only droplets when somebody coughs or sneezes, but also happens when these droplets fall on the table or surrounding areas, like the common areas like bathroom handles, tables, common public places, rails, or any handles and all. And when you touch them, and then again the hand goes to your nose and mouth, probably unknowingly to many of the times. So those, again, these droplets infect you. So you need to have a frequent hand wash whenever you come in contact with any common public places. I think we all now started preparing ourselves to face any kind of this epidemic outbreak. How I actually, as a common man, know that this hospital is geared up. See, every hospital has now been, or every corporate or a bigger medical colleges has now been geared with an isolation ward along with isolation rooms, and also the personal protective equipments which are geared up. And they have actually information pamphlets or information labelings given to you at the entry of the gate key. Whenever you get across, come across with the fever, cough and breathlessness, what are the precautions you need to take and do? So all the corporates, bigger corporates and medical colleges in the state of both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana has been alerted for this. Health workers should also follow the same standard respiratory etiquette, like whenever they are in healthcare working atmospheres, they should be using a regular surgical or medical mask. And then hand wash, hand hygiene has to be on the priority, and they should be using a frequent hand washing technique, hand hygiene technique. They should not be touching the face and nose whenever they are actually coming across with this healthcare system. And when they are actually coming across with somebody invasively doing a procedures like bronchoscopy or intubation, coming with aerosolized procedures, they should be using an N95 mask. The rest all the situation, the surgical or medical mask will be enough. And respiratory etiquette, whenever they sneeze, cough, they make sure that they cover with some elbow and they don't touch the hands in those situations. See, right now we are actually skipping from stage one, that is any of our person who traveled abroad and coming with from the countries which actually have a high prevalence of COVID-19 viral infection, and they detected to have this virus in our country is in stage one. When these patients or these persons infect the next contact persons nearby, when they come across, we come across a stage called stage two. From this stage two, where this contact has got this virus, if this spreads into the community, we come across a stage three. Stop the spread in the stage three. We have to stop this gatherings, mass gatherings, malls, movie theaters or schools, to stop this spread from one person to the other. So at this point of time, we are in high point where we have to stop this social gatherings or mass gatherings to avoid this transmission in the community. Suppose any person who came in contact with any of the known COVID-19 case which is diagnosed or a suspected case, these people or these persons were asked to self-isolate at home, where these persons will be observed for 14 days at home, where these persons will not probably allowed to go out of the home and keep themselves inside a home with their own ear, so that after the 14 days, if the patient or this person doesn't get any symptoms or signs, they will be freed. So this is called self-isolation to not transmit this infection to the others. Predominant deaths or fatality happened in the age group above 60 or those who has a comorbid conditions like diabetes, hypertensive or some respiratory diseases. So we see this strong correlation between the age and this comorbidity. So we strongly recommend the elderly age group population and those who has a comorbidities to stay home, isolate themselves from social gatherings or mass gatherings. I think at this point of time, all the non-urgent travels to the corona-affected places or countries is already been sealed. So if you have already traveled to a corona-affected place, so you came back from that area, so first point is you will be screened in the airport authority for your temperature or any symptoms. If you have a symptoms, they will screen. Otherwise, you will be asked to self-isolate for 14 days. What you are supposed to do in this 14 days, during this period, if you develop any symptoms related to the high-grade fever, dry cough or breathlessness, you should be reporting back to the nodal center where you will be tested for COVID-19, and if you come positive, you will be isolated till you recover and the treatment and other supportive care will be taken care of.